Hi, welcome to Delta Sustainable Garden Classes. I'm Kristin Crouch. So we've got all our flowers on the table here. Let's make a bouquet. Now I have to, heads up, I'm not a florist, so I'm an amateur at this, but I love playing with flowers just to see if I can actually create something beautiful. And you know, it's just for me. So the first thing I want to do is like, what vase am I going to use? And usually the vase I'm using, or what depends on the flowers in bloom. If I've got a lot of pink and purple flowers, then I'll probably use something pretty like this that I got from my mom, and isn't it beautiful? And you can put a nice bouquet in there. But if, say, if I've got some fall flowers or some hot colors, like the reds and the yellows, they look awesome. You know, the crocosmia coming out of the vase with some red zinnias or yellows and oranges, it looks great. Now, if I'm looking for a really small bouquet, maybe you're just going to do a few small flowers, you're going to use a really tiny vase. And the key is just make sure your vases are clean before you use them. And you know, when you arrange your flowers, you're going to want to refill that, refill the water, change the water every day. And you may want to recut your stems a couple of every few days. So that's what I do in the garden. But these little vases are good too. If you want like a small vase of flowers that doesn't sort of impede your guests at the table, you can use a small one. So to get started, I'm going to pick this vase because I've got a lot of pinks and purples in the garden. And the first thing I'm going to do is select my greenery. So the greenery, and I've decided I want to use the amaranth. And I'm going to just bring my basket over here. We're going to use that to strip off the leaves because I'm not going to use any of these lower leaves. I'm also going to give the fresh flowers another cut, a little bit on the diagonal so there's more surface area. And let's see how that fits in the vase. It's still a little bit long. So sometimes you have to play with the length and how you want it to sit in the vase. I've got a few here. I'll probably be wishing I had more because what I like about this is I love the leaves on it as well and the drooping fabric. It just gives you that trailing habit in the vase. I'm not going to cut that and take these lower leaves off and see how that sits in the vase. Yeah, that might be not too bad. You know, if you had it on a mantle, it could just droop off the edge of a mantle. I'm just going to take that off and pop it in there. And let's get one more stem. So I tend to go by that rule of threes. So I kind of use about three stems of each. Sometimes I may need more depending on the width of the vase on the top. You can see this pruners, I could probably sharpen those. I could have probably used a pair of scissors to cut the stem to get that little bit off. And there we go. And I'm going to put one on the back too. So I'm probably going to arrange it from the back. And you can see here I've got, if I turn it around, you can see what I'm looking at. I'm looking at those flowers and I just love the way they cascade over the edge of the vase. So the next thing I'm going to look at is some of my filler flowers. What am I going to use? So I think that I'm going to pick up some of the parsley flowers greenery that I had in there and I'm going to recut the stem again. And I'm just going to pop it in there. Now there's lots of things you can do, like when you've got a really wide vase, sometimes you roll up chicken wire and you put it inside and that can keep your flowers stable in the vase. This vase is not usually a problem. Some people use scotch tape or waterproof floral tape across the vase to create a grid, but it's, you know, it's whatever you want to use. And you know, like this is just for the home, just for me, but if you were doing it like for professional florists, you know, you'd want to obviously use some tips and tricks from those. Let's see what else we want. Maybe another bit of greenery, but maybe, yeah, I've got one more. I'm just pulling them out of a jar here, so they're all coming with me. That's obviously, we're going to put one on this side too. I love the way it contrasts against the leaves. So we've got a little bit of filler in there. I really, really love these feverfew. This is that snowball one that I talked about earlier. I'm going to take off a lot of the lower leaves. Sometimes the leaves are not the best. And you don't want them, like I said, you don't want them under water. We'll just cut that stem. I think I'm going to lose one of those. Kind of wish I had more of this. But it looked nice. And look at, they're like little buttons in the arrangement. So the next flower I'm going to use, let's see what else we could use. Oh, I've got some white salvia here, which gives you a bit of a bird. I actually planted all blue salvia and this one bloomed white. So how does that happen? It gives you a little bit of a vertical accent, but also gives you a little bit of a silver contrast in there. I like that silver there look on the plants. Let's see what else we got. Let me add a little bit more white. So I've got some white status here as well. White can fit into almost any arrangement. So it's nice to have a little bit of white just to brighten it up. And then we're going to add some apricot status as well because it goes nicely with, I probably would rather have used pink, but we'll use this apricot. So, you know, if you don't, the thing is, if you don't like it, you can always You can always take it apart. You know, that's the thing with arranging flowers. Let's cut that stem. And sometimes you may want to leave, like in nature, nothing kind of grows symmetrically. Everything kind of grows every which way. So there's not really a way to put flowers in. You just want to do it the way you want them. So let's take a look around. I want to see how it looks from the front. The status is on the high side here. It would be nice to have it as my center there for a minute. I'll just arrange that. And let's see, let's take a Cosmo. I love these Cosmos because they're such, you know what's nice is you're marrying the colors together. So basically I'm taking colors that kind of blend with each other. And from the garden, I'm going to give it a fresh cut and we'll pop it in there. That looks great. And then I've got this one. Look at this Sweet William. This is the Diantha Sweet William that we talked about earlier. And we're just going to put that in, but I'll remove those leaves. And I'm just going to cut it a bit shorter because it's going to be too tall if I don't. I could spend hours just doing this every day. So if you're ever looking for a bouquet, just come by the garden. I'm sure I've got, I never can tell if there's any flowers. And I'll put this white one in the back here because we've got white at the front here. We've got a little bit of white status on this side. And then we've got some white here. So I'm kind of trying to balance it out. Let's see what other color. I could put this light purple in or I could add some pink. Choices, choices, right? I think what I'll do is I'll add a little bit more Sweet William in the pink to the center of the arrangement. There we go. And then of course I can't not use the zinnia. And I'm going to take the leaves off this because we've got a lot of leaves in the arrangement already. So we don't need any extras. We're going to pop that on top, right in the center there. I'm going to turn that around because the only thing that I would probably add to this is maybe something for height, but it's not too bad. I can see something here. We need a little bit of balance on this side. So maybe I'll add in this dahlia here. It's on the short side, so we're just going to pop it in the side here. I mean, they're just so beautiful. I mean, you really can't go wrong mixing flowers together. And, you know, if you wanted some height from some plants, then the bunny tail grass is kind of nice to use too. Now, we don't need it too high. So you might have to recut it more, you know, these are really thin stem plants. So you got to be really careful with these guys, but it adds some movement to the bouquet. If you can see what I mean, there we go. We'll cut another stem. There we go. Remove that leaf. Put another stem in. I don't know if I've got another one here. Now I would have liked to have added another one. I could probably use some verbena in here just to offset the purple, give it a little bit more height in the center. Whoops, probably should have cut that a little bit longer. So that was my mistake there. You could add something else. I'm just going to look around here because it's actually turning out. I'm pretty happy with this so far. So just take a spin around and if you feel you need a little bit of color somewhere, you can always stick something in. Like I can probably put, the only thing was sometimes with Cosmos, you see how that's bending like that? It's going to bend, but then you're not going to be able to see it very well in the vase. So I'm going to take a look. This rose is probably too big, but we could put this dahlia in. Let's see. Now it's pretty big for the vase. So, you know, once you get in there, you'll find that you don't need as many really large flowers. So we'll skip that one for now. And let me just see if I can put maybe a white daisy in there just to give us some more color in the top there. And there's white on the side there. Let's see which one here. We've got this little pink Cosmo here. It's pretty cute. I'm gonna cut it and we'll just fit that in. I'm trying to figure out what side to go. Let's see. I think that we could probably just pop it in the top here because Cosmos all grow together, so why not? Let's pop it in. If it's too long, you can recut your stems. And you know, it's nice, you can fiddle around with them, but I think that we can call that pretty well done. I'm happy with that. What do you think? Anyway, I probably would have used one more bunny tail grass in there, but then I've got this other spike because you want a little bit of a vertical lift in your arrangements as well. But I think that's good enough to go on my patio table today.